Good morning. My name is Melissa Goist. I am a associate clinical professor in obstetrics and gynecology at the Ohio State Wexner Medical Center. And today I'm going to be talking to you about updates on COVID-19 and pregnancy. Although unfortunately the data is limited thus far, based on the last few months here in the United States, and of course probably the last 6 months or so throughout the rest of the world, the research and information we have so far with pregnancy is somewhat reassuring. Historically, many viruses such as H1N1 and SARS have notably caused pregnant women more severe illness. But this virus, COVID-19, does not seem to show an increased severity in the pregnancy population. About 80% of patients who are COVID-19 positive are able to recover at home with rest, hydration, acetaminophen, which is very reassuring news. And of course, we don't even know how many patients have COVID-19 because of the testing as it is right now. And as more people get tested, we'll have better information on overall outcomes and severity of this disease process. But all in all, right now, it does not seem that the pregnant population is any more vulnerable to this virus than their counterpart, female. So if you're a healthy 32-year-old who's pregnant, you are at no higher risk of severe illness than your non-pregnant counterpart. It is important to keep in mind, though, that pregnancies that are complicated by other comorbidities, such as high blood pressure, significant asthma, other immunocompromised states, these patients are more susceptible to severe illness and still need to be very cautious. But don't get me wrong, the pregnant population is still at high risk for getting COVID-19. We are all at high risk for getting COVID-19 because this is a novel virus, which means that we all still need to be safe, whether we're pregnant or not. And that safety means to follow the stay-at-home guidelines based on our governor's recommendation, as well as practicing safe social distancing, working remotely when feasible, using personal protective equipment when appropriate, good hand hygiene, trying to reduce touching your face. So all of the recommendations made to the non-pregnant population are similar in the pregnancy population. Now, what do you do if you are concerned that you are exposed to the coronavirus or that you have COVID-19? Specifically, prior to showing up at any office or showing up at the hospital, we are strongly encouraging our patients to call your primary care provider first, whether that be your obstetrician or your internal medicine doctor or your family medicine doctor. The reason for this is because there are different tiers to testing based on the state of Ohio's recommendations. The other concern is that we don't want you coming to the office and potentially inadvertently exposing the rest of the patients that are there. So we do want to know if you're concerned. We do want to know if you're concerned about exposure or illness based on your symptoms. As the state of Ohio's tracking starts to ramp up with more testing and businesses opening, I'm certain that we will have additional recommendations by Dr. Acton moving forward as to how to test and who to test when patients are concerned about exposure or have gotten a call about specific exposure to someone who has tested positive. What many patients have probably realized is that the office visits have changed a little bit in terms of the obstetric population. We have tried to take a very conservative approach to the obstetric visits, trying to consolidate visits and stretching out visits to avoid inadvertent exposure from other patients in the office, as well as to give our staff ample opportunity to make sure that the environment is clean and safe. As you've also recognized, there have been no visitors at these appointments, so no support people at this time. We do encourage you to put your support person on speakerphone or FaceTime when appropriate to either listen to the heartbeat or ask questions. We by no means want to make the support person feel unwelcome. We are just trying to keep our environment in this as safe as possible. And as soon as the governor and Ohio State determines that we can go back to our routine appointments, we will be doing so in the office. And I think that's going to be here within the next few months or so. Different things that you'll see at the hospital level. As you enter the hospital in for delivery, you are continued to allow one support person at this time. Both of you will be screened upon admission and given a mask prior to entering labor and delivery. I would strongly encourage patients to discuss with their primary obstetric provider where to go if you are in labor in the middle of the night. Many of the entrances at specifically OSU have been detoured to other entrances in order to allow for the appropriate screening prior to entering the hospital. And this means that you may be parking in a different parking garage than what you were expecting based on either the booklet we gave you at the beginning or if you were able to take a tour of the hospital. So I'd strongly encourage you to talk to your provider about that to make sure you know where you're going in the middle of the night. On labor and delivery, typically if you are a COVID patient and you're COVID positive or a patient under investigation and you're having your baby, you're in labor or having a C-section, you will be isolated from the other patients in your own labor and delivery room that has the appropriate negative airflow in order to avoid exposure. For patients who are COVID-19 positive or patients under investigation and pregnant but not having their baby, they are separated off unit onto the COVID unit of the hospital in order to avoid any inadvertent exposure to our other pregnant patients. You will notice that there potentially will be early discharge from the hospital. So if you've had a newborn in the past, you may have stayed in the hospital for 2 days after a vaginal birth or 3 days after a C-section. If our moms and newborns are healthy, early discharge is possible as long as we feel that that is safe and the patient feels that it is safe to be discharged home. For patients who are COVID-19 positive or patients under investigation, at the time of delivery, there will be a conference between you, your obstetrician, and the pediatrician about recommendations for your newborn. We are still encouraging breastfeeding for our COVID-19 patients, if possible, based on the health of the mom. But there are some different recommendations in regards to wearing a mask at the time of breastfeeding, as well as social distancing with the newborn in the labor and delivery and postpartum room. So these recommendations will be reviewed with you at the time of your admission to the hospital to make sure we're doing what is best for the patient as well as the newborn. These guidelines are evolving and they're very fluid. So over the next several weeks, you may hear new guidelines in regards to labor and delivery and breastfeeding and appointments as more and more knowledge is obtained about COVID-19 and pregnancy. The final thing I want to discuss is the mental health of the new mom. I do think that it's a very unnerving time, and pregnancy in and of itself can be have a lot of anxiety associated with it. And in these situations, sometimes moms struggle to be able to feel that they can appropriately deal with these worries and concerns. So please know that we are here for you as your obstetric providers to either help guide you, to help counsel you, or to point you in the right direction to make sure you're feeling that you are able to take care of yourself as well as your newborn in the best manner. Thanks so much for listening today and joining me on this Facebook Live event. I'm new to Facebook and new to this, so I apologize for any jitters or mistakes that I made. I'm happy to take any questions. I have about 5 minutes left to go through questions if you have any. Thanks. Hi, Josh. Thanks for your question. Josh asked, his wife is delivering at OU. In the next few weeks, will she wear a mask during labor and delivery? That's a great question. At this point, the recommendation is that you and your wife will both be wearing masks while in labor and delivery room when there is either a provider or a nurse in the room with you, as we'll be wearing masks as well. But currently, we are not requiring our mom wear masks during the specifically with the pushing process. So you can alleviate some of her fears that she won't need to be wearing that mask during the pushing process, at least right now. Hi, Katie. Thanks for your question about keeping newborns safe. Honestly, I do think at this point with this Ohio and the recommendation continuing with social distancing, that you show off your baby on social media for the next couple of weeks. And then as things continue to evolve in the state and we start to reopen up, hopefully you'll have friends and family come and visit as soon as we feel that it's appropriate. But yes, I agree. I think at this point it is really difficult, especially from a support perspective, that people can't have friends and family around. But I do think from a newborn perspective, at this point, you should try to keep those new grandmas and grandpas away. Hi, Ashley. Good question about baby showers and seeing friends and family. I still think at this point, pregnant women should try to isolate as much as possible. Again, although the pregnancy population does not seem to be more vulnerable when it comes to this illness, I think it would be miserable if you did get sick, period. So for as much as we can socially isolate, clearly, if you have a small baby shower with appropriate social distancing, no hugging, no kissing of your friends and family, then you may be able to do that. But I think within the next month to 2 months, we will definitely be seeing the recommendations increase in terms of number of people that can be together. Right now, I think Governor DeWine has recommended no more than 10 people together. Hi, Melissa. Thanks for the shout out. Kristen, good question. Our second time pregnant mom to preeclampsia with their first visit at higher risk. No, currently the research does not suggest that you are, unless you otherwise have chronic hypertension prior to the preeclampsia or with this pregnancy. So it is okay, and we still recommend the use of the baby aspirin to reduce your risk of preeclampsia. We think that that's safe even if you do have COVID-19, because we know the benefits are so significant for many patients. So I would say, you know, stay safe, stay healthy, but I do not believe that you are at any higher risk for having more severe illness. Hi, I have a question. Do we have to or recommend quarantine 2 weeks prior to term date? I think this is going to be my last question because I've gone over the 15 minutes, which I knew I would. I should have warned Kelly that I talked a lot. And we'll get to the rest of the questions. We'll certainly get your answers via Facebook. We'll finish answering them, but my event is only supposed to be 15 minutes. ACOG, which is the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology, states that prior to delivery, 2 weeks prior to delivery, you could consider quarantining patients specifically who are not able to work remotely during this time to avoid inadvertent exposure prior to delivery. So this, I think, is something that the patients have to have with their provider. It is not an absolute recommendation, definitely something to be taken into consideration, especially with our patients who aren't able to work remotely and have access to other patients or direct contact with other patients. I hope this answers all your questions. Thanks so much, guys, for being here. Happy Mother's Day to all of you moms out there, and hopefully the weekend will look up. All right, take care.